Hi friends, welcome to Wafa Studies. This is part 20 in Azure Data Factory video series. In this video, we are going to discuss about system variables available in Azure Data Factory. So the main agenda is to know about system variables in Azure Data Factory. So actually what these system variables are actually, these are like inbuilt variables are provided in the Azure Data Factory, which you can make use inside your expressions so that you can pass the dynamic values to it. Okay, so these expressions will resolve to values during runtime. Okay, so these system variables in Azure Data Factory are available at three levels. One is pipeline level, and second is for schedule trigger, there are few available, and also for tumbling window trigger. Okay, so let me open this URL here. I have already opened. So if you go this URL, you can see all the variables, system variables available for you at different levels of scopes. At pipeline level scope, you can find all these variables actually. So pipeline, data factory, pipeline, pipeline run ID, trigger type, trigger ID, trigger name, trigger time. So all these variables will convert into values when you use these variables inside expressions during runtime. Okay. So for example, this particular variable, this will give the data factory name, and this will give the pipeline name, and run ID will give the pipeline execution ID. Okay. So if you are not clear about run ID, let me quickly explain you. This is my Azure Data Factory ADF demo Mahir. I have opened it in edit mode here. So for example, this pipeline actually, what it is doing is, this is copying data from one storage to another storage. That means same storage actually, and copying data from one folder to another folder. Okay. So whenever you run any pipeline, right, either using a trig or either using a manual trigger, let me quickly do a manual trigger now. So whenever you do that execution of any pipeline, right, so the executions you can monitor under this monitor tab actually. Okay, so I have not explained about this monitor tab yet in our play series. We will discuss that in near future. Okay, so for now you need to get an idea about what is this one, right, what is this run ID. So now if you go to monitor tab, you can see here the execution, the status is successful, and it is a manual trigger type, and what is the duration and when it started and what is the pipeline name. You can scroll all the way till towards right, you can find something called run ID. So what this run ID is actually unique ID assigned for every pipeline execution. Okay, so if you run this pipeline once again, there will be another entry here with a different run ID. So run ID is unique execution ID for each pipeline. Okay, so you can access that value here. And trigger type, what is the trigger type? In my case here, the trigger type is manual trigger, right? Okay, so that's what. So all these values, trigger ID, trigger name, trigger time, when actually triggered, all these values you will be able to access using these system variables. So now if you are wondering what is the exact use of it, what I can say is, let's think about a scenario like this. For example, what I want to do is, in my pipeline, I want to copy data from one storage to another storage, and then I want to log details related to the pipeline execution into some SQL DB. So I want to maintain that pipeline execution's log somewhere inside some DB. So this is what I want to do. So in that case, by seeing the requirement, okay, once this CAPI activity completes, then I need to have some activity here which will take the values of pipeline name and pipeline execution time and also pipeline run ID, all other details, and that values I should be able to store inside the SQL DB. So this is what our requirement, right? So in these cases, what you can do, you can use of these particular system variables here under pipeline scope, and you can make use of it. How to do it? Quickly I will show you. Let's go to edit mode. Okay, so let me quickly create one pipeline. Okay, so I'm just showing it for you. I'm not going to run anything. I'm quickly just trying to add something. So this is pipeline 3. Let's say I have a copy activity here. I'm not doing any configuration. So let's assume this is doing a copy of data from one storage to another storage. After that, there is something called stored procedure. Okay, so what this activity actually does is, stored procedure actually runs a stored procedure, whatever the stored procedure you have configured inside your DB. So for this stored procedure activity, let's assume my stored procedure actually takes 5 to 6 parameters, and each parameter is nothing but, one parameter is data factory name, another parameter is pipeline name, another parameter is run ID, trigger type, trigger ID, trigger name, and trigger trigger time. So all these values it required as a parameters inside my stored procedure. So once I pass to that stored procedure, the stored procedure will execute and store data into some log table. Let's assume such a stored procedure is already there. So by seeing this requirement, now I need all those values to pass to this particular stored procedure activity as a parameter set. So in that case, what you will do, you will create a parameters here. Let's assume this is ADF name, data factory name. Okay. Now the value, right? What you can do is, you no need to hard code it, because if you hard code also in future, if some changes happens, so that is not the best approach, right? So it should be dynamic. So that is the reason you can click this add dynamic content. You can see under system variables, all these variables, whatever I am explaining here, they are available here for you. So you no need to remember them. So what you can do, you can just click, come here and select this value, click finish. So this will give the data factory name. So similarly, let's assume I want run ID, pipeline run ID. So what I can do for value, I can just select this, scroll down, add dynamic content, here select the pipeline run ID. So this will give me run ID, click finish. So in this way, using these expressions, by using these system variables, we are able to get all those values. Okay. So so this is how you will actually do. So what you need to do, you need to just configure everything properly here. So how to do all these configurations, all these linked services and everything, we have discussed everything in our past videos. So please watch all my videos in sequence order. Okay. So this is how it works when it comes to the system variables in pipeline scope. Let me move forward to the schedule trigger scope. So for example, if you are using a schedule trigger for any pipeline, so in that case, there are two system variables available for you. One is schedule time, another one is start time. Schedule time, actually what it will do is, whatever the schedule time is there for that particular trigger, that value it will give you. Start time actually gives you the exact time when the pipeline execution started. For example, let's assume this is 1st June 2017. Okay, at 22:20, so that is 22:20 during this time is the schedule time. So once this schedule time reaches, your pipeline execution will start, right? So it is not like something like exactly at 22:20 it will not start. There might be some seconds and milliseconds also, right? So that accurate value you can get it using this start time. You can see here same date and same time, but there are some nanoseconds also appended here, right? This is the exact time when your pipeline invoked for the execution. This is the scheduled time. Okay, so whenever you use the scheduled trigger, you will get access, you can use these two system variables inside the expressions. So I have explained about scheduled triggers here actually in my previous videos, that is part 8. Please watch them. So for example, let's assume this same procedure, or okay, let me open this notepad. Let's assume what I want to do is, I want to create a pipeline which will copy data from one storage to another storage, and it will run every day. Okay, so what I want to do is, inside my pipeline, let's assume I have used a query actually. So inside that query, I need to pass a value for the current business date, current date to which you want to process the data. So that date should be execution date. That is what my requirement. So in that case, what you can do is, whenever you create a schedule trigger, you can use these system variables here to pass the values of the current execution timings and dates to the pipeline. How to do it? Let me quickly show you. So let me quickly create a pipeline. Let's assume this is the pipeline which actually does. I am not adding any activities here. Let's assume I have already added activity which will take a date, and it will filter the data based on that date and process that particular data. So let's create a trigger for it. So select this new. Let's assume I am creating a schedule trigger. Okay. So, okay. Click OK. Okay. See, it is saying pipeline has no parameters, right? First, what I need to do is, I need to create a parameter which will take this execution date. So let me create a parameter at pipeline level. So let's say this is execution date. So what I want to do is, whatever the current date, that date value I have to pass here. So now let's create this new trigger, create new scheduled one. So now click OK. I'm not changing anything. Okay, click me cancel. Let me click cancel and select this to daily. So this is what my requirement is, every one day. Okay, click OK. So now here, right, for this parameter, what value I want to pass? So my value should be dynamic, and it should be the business date or the execution date. So to do that, what I can do is, I can take this schedule trigger and I can use this one here. Okay, this particular thing will give me the entire date and timing. So what after that, what I can do is I can filter this. There is another function called something called like format date time. Okay, so you can use that for this particular variable, system variable, and by specifying the date format. So let's assume I want only date part. So what I can do is y, then mm, then dd. So in that way I can able to convert this particular value of the system variable into complete date, and I can use that particular date inside my pipeline to process the data for that date alone. Okay, so hope this given idea about how this schedule trigger scope variables help you. So coming to the tumbling window trigger scope variables, there are two variables available: window start time and window end time. I will strongly recommend to watch this part 9 tumbling window trigger in Azure Data Factory, then only you will understand actually. So what tumbling window trigger will do is it will create the schedules for every window, and every window has a start and end timings. I have explained about these two variables in the part 9th video, how to use it. So it's nothing but the same requirement. Okay, so let's assume I want to process the data every 1 hour in the same fashion. By passing the start timing and the end timing. So in that case, you can do like this. So this is the pipeline. Let's assume it has the activity which will process the data for every 1 hour. But for this pipeline, you need to pass the two parameters: what is the start time, and also what is the end time. So let's assume you need to pass these two. Let me create another variable. Let me say this end time. Okay. So now in these cases, what you need to do is, let me create a tumbling window trigger for this new. Let's select the tumbling window. So what I want to do is every 1 hour. Okay, so let me do that. Click OK. So here, right, I want to pass the window start time and window end time. For example, from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. I should be able to pass those values. So in that case, what I can do is I can take these values. I can simply use them here. So these system variables will give those values. Okay. So after that, on top of that, whatever you want to achieve based upon your requirement, you can do it. Okay, so like this, simply you need to do it. So once I publish and once you run your pipelines, right, it will do all the necessary activity for you, and it will dynamically generate the values for all these system variables, whatever we have so far discussed. Okay, so let me quickly go to presentation. Hope this given a clear idea about system variables. Thank you. Please subscribe to my channel and press bell icon to get notifications whenever I add videos. Thank you.